Hello and welcome back to Valkyria Chronicles. This is chapter 14, Loss Within Victory. Wee victory stuffs and losses. Mostly victory stuffs, hooray!
Mr. Organs, but she's still out cold, huh? Come on, boss. There ain't nothing we can do for her cooped up in here. We really got our hands full, keeping those imps from crashing down on top of us.
Yeah, you're right. We'll be back soon, Alicia.
Lieutenant Gunther, might I have a word?
Hmm? Sure, what's up?
Well, it's... I'd feel more comfortable if we could talk alone.
Right. I'll head on back to the squad, boss.
Thanks, Largo. Get everyone ready to move out.
I'm sorry to keep you. I know you've got a squad to run here.
It's fine. What is it?
Well, I removed the bullet from Alicia's body, but when I took a look at it, The bullet wasn't of Imperial make. It was a Gallian sniper rifle round, sir.
What?
And not just a normal round, either. It's part of a new series, still in testing.
So you're saying you think Alicia was shot by someone on our side?
I can't be completely sure, but I believe it's a very real possibility.
But why? What would anyone stand to gain from shooting someone in their own camp?
Ah, those incompetents! Why are they letting the Empire have their way?
With all due respect, General, our army isn't equipped to fight a Valkyria. We ought to pull back for now and think of a strategy to neutralize her safely.
Ah, quiet! Quiet! If we pull out now, how will I explain this to the higher-ups? Tomorrow at noon, we march on to the Empire again. Every soldier we have fights!
General!
Know your place, Varat. You are dismissed.
This is hopeless. We'll lose the whole army. Isn't there... What can we do?
To me, Gallia. Cast aside your weapons and surrender. If you do not, Nagia's plains will drink deeply of your blood.
Wait a minute. I don't believe it.
Thank you.
She can't be a Valkyria!
Another scion to the Valkyro? This world has no need for two. Get out!
So that was a thing. Technically, if you were paying attention to the story, you already knew she was a Valkyrie, but you know, she's kind of like in some sort of trance. I don't know how I feel about that trance situation going on. Do we get to use a Valkyrie now? The heck was that sound? What is my PS3 doing? Hold on a second here. PS3 was making some sort of weird sound. I don't know what it was doing, but it seems to have stopped now. So, we'll be there. They'll be there. We'll kill them. Hooray. Theoretically. Objective is occupation of the enemy's base camp. Okay. We'll come from the captain or highest ranked officer present. Okay. Fucking dies! Nothing about Alicia. I don't even know if we... No, don't deploy yet. What do we have? We have two tanks. We have Rosie and Largo, probably. Yep, they're all required. We may as well get... Let's get Oscar, because we're going to end up having... I guess we'll end up having Jan, because he seems to be alright. Who else do we need? Do we need nobody? Who else do we want, is the question I meant to say there. Desert bread? Yes, please. Desert allergy? No, please. Child of nature? Country bread? You like Frisia, don't you? You like Salinas. Salinas likes Frisia. Okay, Eddie and Salinas. So we have three shock troopers, one scout? Maybe we should have two scouts. Two shock troopers, two scouts, two heavies. Sorry, lancers, whatever you want to call the stupid things. Engineer and a sniper. Seems reasonable to me.
Stay sharp out there.
I will. I'll try to. I don't know about that, and I can't really sharpen myself mid-combat if I get blunted, but hey. I don't know what I'm going on about, but I am going on about something. It's kind of a thing I do, and just kind of ramble needlessly. Attack of a loading screen. There we go.
Concentrate on taking their base camp. Squad 7, move out.
Right-a-ho. What is Alicia doing? Is what I'm curious about. She's here, apparently. She's there, standing currently.
Boss, what's happened to Alicia?
No, but that blue flame is the same as that Valkyria's.
You don't mean... You saying Alicia's Valkyria?
I'm curious where she got the shield and the spear from. Who walked in that night and gave it to her?
Looks like she's acting unconsciously. Get too close, she might attack us.
Okay.
But we're better off watching for now. In the meantime, we strike their camp.
I like how she just casually walks around. How far can she walk, I wonder? It's probably scripted, considering she has no action bar. Or action points, or whatever. And she uses that on everything, rather than... I assume she uses that on everything, rather than the Gatling beam. She gets two turns. Ooh. I feel this is going to be an unnecessarily long mission as we watch her slowly walk around. Like how she just rotates suddenly. I can spin the camera. There's an anti-tank and a machine gun there. Machine gun, looks like a destroyer. That's the first I've seen anything that looks like that. It seems like a destroyer. It doesn't have a turret. And she's done. I was kind of really wishing she would kill the things on the left side. The tank destroyer, yes. So imagine that hits like a truck. Do we just wait? That's the base we have to take. There's a ladder there. If we have an angle on that heavy anti-tank gun, we could probably use Oscar to kill it. Let's see if we do. Because remember, heavy anti-tank guns are just dudes on guns. I don't believe you can get headshots on them. No, it still takes 6 shots. You can give them a damage boost. I want to kill the heavy anti-tank gun, and then I'll just use my own tank to kill the machine gun bunker, I guess? Let's see what kind of orders we have. What is anti-personnel? Attack is anti-personnel. Okay. Let's just use an attack boost.
This is an order.
We don't need all units attack boosts, because he's the only one that's probably going to be shooting this guy. I don't even know if this... I guess this is anti-personnel. It is a personnel. I'm about to find out. 5 shots of kill. Did absolutely nothing, so it's probably anti-tank damage that we would want to look at. You know, I may not even need to do this. I can just take the tank and shoot it, but... Whatever. Hopefully... Okay, he's still fine. Although he'll probably get shot by that machine gun. Whatever, let's take our... Edelweiss. And move it a bit forward here. Hopefully Alicia doesn't turn around and shoot me in the face. That'd be kind of painful. What's my accuracy from here? Not that good. Can I hit it with a mortar? Almost can. Would it kill it if I hit it with a mortar becomes the next question. Might as well try. For science. Turns out the answer is no, but, you know. Science was achieved this day. I took a huge risk doing that, considering there's a freaking tank destroyer right there, but...
On the move now.
Hopefully... We'll be alright. Actually, no, we won't, because the enemy turn is next, and that's going to take 2 shots to go.
Great.
Of course, he has 8 freaking hit points left. That seems perfectly fine. Let's move the Shamrock up as well. Maybe we can at least kill this anti-tank gun. He can fire mortars, much smaller mortars, I believe, but still he can fire mortars. Not as far. Such a low chance to kill.
Right in front of you.
I'm worried about that tank destroyer. I don't know how much damage that thing can do. And if this misses, I'm going to be sad. This thing has no accuracy because it has no upgrades. It missed. Barely, but it did miss. Uh, we can't move anyone close enough because of that machine gun bunker. He's out of ammo. I could take another 2 CP and have the Edelweiss shoot it.
Here we go.
Yeah, I really do want that anti-tank gun dead.
Gotta love nature.
I don't really need the... Well, I probably do need the tank destroyer dead, but I'm not terribly worried about it. Please hit. Thank you. Could have just done that shot to begin with and saved a whole lot of AP, but... And CP, for that matter, but whatever. It's fine, it's fine. Let's move... Fuzi up. Towards the right side, I guess. I don't know where I'm going with anyone. Just kind of casually follow Alicia, I guess. I can't go past that, as it turns out. Have you? This is news to me and probably everyone else involved. That won't even hurt you, so just sit there. That machine gun bunker will take a shot at someone, I'm sure, and so will the tank destroyer, but... Hopefully we'll be alright. I mean, if it one-shots the Edelweiss, we're gonna be in trouble, so... I'd request reinforcements, too. Oh, he's gonna fire a mortar at Alicia. Does that also stun her like it... Nope, she blocks it. I was gonna ask if it stuns her like it stuns, Oh! That's a cannon bunker. Like it stuns... Oh, blarg words, whatever. You know who I mean. Leave me alone. I wonder if there's explosives behind that bunker. I wonder if it'll matter or if she's just gonna go kill the bunker. You know what it is, she's probably scripted to walk over here and then fire at that bunker so she hits it and the gun. No, she's gonna fire at the tank, sure. And one shot it. Yeah, that makes sense. Seems logical to me. Oh, she turned around. Turned around to kill Seema the Elder. Okay. I guess she's just not gonna move that turn. I'm really worried that she's gonna, like, shoot at me. If I run someone past her, I'm afraid she's just gonna shoot at us. I'm still at an A rank? I'm still at an A rank. Do I want to risk it? Let's see. Let's take a suicide scout, basically, and see. Does she angrily start shooting at me? Hi, Alicia. Please, don't murder me. Thank you. So that was easy. I wish every mission... No, I don't. I wish every mission that was that easy. It's gonna be a short video if that's the whole mission. Oh yeah, she's almost dead. I forgot about that bit. And unconscious, but, you know. Details.
Alicia! Medic! Medic!
What happened?
Hello.
It looks like Alicia's passed out. Can you get her back to base for me?
Yes, Alicia's sir. Out here? What? Oh.
What now?
Massive tanks are approaching from the north and south.
Okay.
Be careful, Lieutenant. It's a pincer attack.
They left the camp open as bait to lure us in.
Those tanks fire incendiary rounds. The impact explodes into a broad blaze. That flame can get at you even in trenches and takes a while to die down. Be careful.
Change of plans, Sevens. Hold the camp and take down those tanks.
I knew it was too easy. I got the objectives actually change halfway through the mission. I think that's the first time that's ever happened. Reinforcements have appeared indeed. So one tank's over there. She can't get anywhere, so... Maybe she can do something about this? No, there's nothing explosive. So that cannon bunker would have to die. What is she looking at behind her? Good lord, there's a lot of dudes. a lancer back there. All right, well, Leisha's no longer here to help us. What can we do about this tank? Good question. What can we do about that? Could attempt to move the tanks into position to deal with it. We could attempt to use lancers to deal with it, which will probably get shot at to death. They have to come from this way, so they would be shot to crap.
Entering combat.
Let's grab the Edelweiss. Alright. How much does it take to kill you? 4 shots through that to kill you. Could probably kill you with a damage boost. There are these tank mines, which I'd rather not hit if physically possible, so just gonna cut around that. Out of curiosity. Unknown amount of shots to kill.
Fire!
Many shots to kill, as it turns out. That's good to know. So optimally, I guess you'd want to. What is that? It's a sniper up there. Ooh, dear. Optimally, you'd want to have tanks ready for this, I guess. I'm gonna damage boost the Edelweiss. If it can't get behind him, I want to at least get good damaging shots off onto the front of him. And then we're gonna have to do something about all these infantry, I imagine. Because I don't think we're going to be able to kill both of these tanks this turn. Just run that guy over, don't mind me. We're not going to be able to get behind this thing. And we're also not going to kill it this time. I mean, it's a turret. You can kill the turrets, apparently. I don't really want to. Alright, that did effectively nothing to the tank. Now we know it does effectively nothing even with damage boost, so... Can I get a shot on his crit? Possibly? No, as it turns out. We're gonna have to turn this thing around, and this is the last CP we've got, so... Didn't turn around far enough, I don't think, so we're probably going to die. Also, it turns out hitting it in the crit point doesn't kill it anyway. So we're probably going to be redoing this mission with our newfound knowledge. Wish you could speed up the... Oh my god, the amount of CP. Wish you could speed up the enemy's turn. Also, those sniper spots? Wow, those are good. I wish I could have snipers up there. How would I do this mission? The two tanks, obviously. A scout, and that's probably it. And not call anyone else in. Nice dodge there, buddy. Why is he already hurt? One of those must have hit him or something, I don't know. Seems bizarre he'd only take one damage. This is going to be an unnecessarily long turn that I'm just going to lose on anyway, because they're going to shoot the Edelweiss in the back. So even with damage boost, shooting this thing in the crit spot was a good shot.
Damn,
it'll be alright, Freezy, don't worry. We're gonna go back in time anyway. And that northern tank, it takes a lot of turns to get anywhere, so... I guess if we just position ourselves on the southern side, ready for this advance, we should be alright. Maybe. Can you just pick the Lancer and shoot the stupid Edelweiss? That's all you have to do. That'll be the last thing he moves. No, he's gonna move the tank first. And shoot me. Maybe one-shot me. Nope. I'd say that's more than minor. It's a very angry tank looking at you. No, that's not the Lancer. There's the Lancer, right there. Look at it, standing there. easy access to crit point on two different tanks. Whatever. Sometimes I wish scouts or snipers could counter fire, but that'd be a bit silly. Still not the Lancer. Glad I failed this mission the first time so we could see this lovely turn of events. Could cut this out. Not going to. Where is this dude going? He must be going to capture the base. That's the base we have to defend, too. Yeah, sure, go ahead and crit the Shamrock. Don't mind the other tank behind you that is, you know, important to the mission.
Sorry. I've got to bail out.
It'll be alright. Oh, that causes the game over, too. Well, there you go. Now we know. Or it doesn't. Never mind. Just causes the sad game over music. Seriously, this turn. It's mission in general. Just sit here watching other people move for 30 minutes. Oh, can they walk through that green stuff? What is that green stuff? Because most of them seem to be avoiding it. It's like grass, maybe. I hate the amount of CP they have. He's going to capture the base this turn, I think. Which would be fine with me, because I want to end the stupid mission anyway. There it goes. Dong.
Damn! We lost the base!
Retreat! There you go. Nice view of her hair outlined. Let us go back to briefing. Change up our unit placement, and we're gonna have to do something here. I don't know what, but something. Yeah, we've seen this before. Skip. I wish you could skip it a little bit faster, but nope, this is the fastest it goes. Position units. Let's grab someone. How about you? How about you? And just that, I think, maybe, possibly. We'll roll with that. And then maybe we'll be able to do, I don't know, we have to do something about those snipers or we're going to be in trouble. What could we do about said snipers?
Concentrate on taking their base camp. Squad 7, move out!
Derp da der, time to watch Alicia slowly waddle towards the enemy base again. It's awfully warm in my room, considering it's like a cold front passing through or something, I don't remember. I don't approve. Boss, what happened to this person? We've already seen this, go away. I wonder how much she's scripted, like where does she go if I just let her wander around? Will she eventually kill all of this stuff for me? If so, I mean, just have at it. Then I'll just spend some turns positioning my tanks or something. I wish I had that, you know. Can we get that in future missions? Can we just have Alicia beam laser everything to death? At least they enthusiastically shoot at her, even though it's obviously not doing anything. I guess she rotates instantly. That's a cool effect that actually comes off her when she gets shot. I also blew up some sandbags back there. Excuse me, Alicia, you're blowing up my cover. I don't appreciate that. Okay, so we have our turn. Let's just, I guess, take the tanks and get them positioned.
Imperial defenses are finally weakening.
Here we go. We'll go ahead and spend 4 CP per tank moving it this way. I should probably rotate the tank as well. Just in case these people over there decide to take pot shots at my tank or something stupid. I don't know. I could take pot shots at them. It'd be insane if I actually hit that, considering the aiming reticule, but hey. Got nothing else to shoot at, I guess. It'll be fine. Alright, so your position for now. Let's go ahead and get the little shamrock in place. Shamrock is very, very mobile and moves fairly quick, to be honest. Has slightly more AP than the Edelweiss does. I bet I could give the Shamrock the 3 CP boost and it'd probably do good enough to kill this thing on its own. Should I test that? Maybe I should test that. It also turns really quick, which I like. Don't do that. Wasting AP wiggling around for no reason. You can't hurt it. The problem is it does less damage than the Edelweiss. Oh, nice hit. I think it does less damage than the Edelweiss. It'd only be logical. You guys can just chill there. Hopefully the bunker and the... Well, not the gun anymore, because the gun's dead. Hopefully that bunker won't shoot at us. And he's going to do the same thing he does last time. Fire his RVD5GPKS1 at us, which is apparently a mortar. Alright, well, that's not something I was expecting it to fire at, but I guess I could have moved them. I like how it still says player phase, but she has her own little, like, CP pool and does stuff herself. I'm thinking maybe I should, because of the way she does this turn, she moves up and shoots this guy, but then shoots the infantry. I wonder if I leave that AT gun up if she'll shoot that instead. And kill the bunker, because she's lined up to hit that and the bunker from where she is. So maybe I'm basically ruining a strategy here by shooting at stuff. You dodged a laser beam. Don't really know how that works, but okay. May as well go ahead and shoot from here, since it's closer. We probably should have done this before when we were moving, but whatever. Nice miss! Imperial defenses are finally weakening. I love the controls on tanks. It's actually quite good. I approve. Controls quite well. I think parked right there should be perfect, and I don't think we'll need to move the Shamrock. It can just move on it then. I don't think we need to move the Edelweiss, but whatever. I probably should have boosted you, but whatever. It's got 3 shots with it. Let's see how much damage he can do. He can even hit it. Should be able to. 5 if he doesn't hit the weak point, 3 if he does. I think he did actually manage to hit the weak point. We're gonna boost Largo. Let's see if it does anything. Orders! Not evade boost. Damage boost. I can greatly raise his anti-tank power, but I don't think we need to. If it even affects bunkers. I guess it is anti-tank that we're firing at him with, but... Excuse me. 3 and 2. I don't think it actually affects bunkers. How do you miss a bunker? You don't miss a bunker. That's not how this works. Alright. I like vegetables too. I don't really, but... That increases his damage quite a bit, by the way, if you didn't know what that did. Come on, crit. Nice, Largo. Very good. All right. It's So all threats to my tanks are gone. All threats to Rosie are gone.
I'm ready to go.
Let's move Frizia up. We are going to need her to capture the base, I presume. So let's get her prepared to do so. I presume he's going to try to shoot at me, so I'm just going to sit down here. And that'll be my turn. Yes, that'll be my turn. Maybe I should try to get a tank to the north? Like, maybe I should... I have so much CP, that's why they had CP right there. I don't do anything. I don't know when, like, if it's scripted to trigger on the base capture, or if Alicia starts doing stuff on her own. Like, if there's no enemies, if she just kind of wanders off and tries to murder us. I don't know. Fire that guy, yeah, alright. Maybe just don't end my turn within range of her. If there's no enemies, I guess. Oh, she disappeared and then she's on the map. I don't know. It's weird. Should I try it? I could capture it this turn. I could start calling in reinforcements. I could kill this one down here and start working on all these infantry. Yeah, we'll do it this way. We'll do it one tank at a time. Please don't murder me, Alicia. That's a mine. There's some mines everywhere. Hi, Alicia. Please don't murder me. I'm always worried about her murdering me, but she doesn't seem to do anything. The game tells you to be worried about her murdering you, so... I got worried about her murdering me. Leave me alone. Medic, etc., etc. Fox! No way, that's the wrong game. Wish you could skip this. Turns out you can't. Because it's not an actual movie. I don't think it's one of those dialogue thingy bobs. You know what I mean. Dialogue thingy bobs. It's a thing with this game. Movies and dialogue thingy bobs all look the same. I think it was actually a movie, though.
Alicia!
Because I had to fade in and out to do it, so. Explosions! Massive tanks are approaching. Explosions! So we have to hold this base, so... What best way to hold base? Who knows? This is probably the best way to keep her alive. Although now they're gonna start taking pot shots at other people, I'm sure. First step, orders! Demolition boost, idle vice. So we're gonna blow 5 CP to kill this thing, hopefully in one turn. If it doesn't kill it in one turn, problem. Problem indeed. Unknown shots to kill. Seriously, does demolition boost just not affect this thing, or what's going on here? I mean, if I give a tank demo boost and shoot something in the crit, you think you'd kill it, considering we can kill heavy tanks with machine guns in 4 shots like that. Either way, it's dead, so... Tank 1 of 2 down.
One enemy tank neutralized! One to go, sir!
I like Isara better. Can we have Isara back?
It won't be long now.
Can Isara be a Valkyria? So she doesn't die? Go ahead and park the idle vice here. probably going to end up firing both of the mortar rounds from these tanks. Well, one mortar round from each tank, anyway. Fire it right here. It did more or less what I wanted it to. So, killed a sniper, killed two other people. Made that guy angry, but not terribly concerned about that.
Leave it to me.
There's a couple things I could do here. This dude's not going to take a lot of damage from a mortar. I could fire the gun at him and just leave these dudes. They're just troopers, so they're not going to be too much of an issue, and try and kill this guy. I think I'll do that. Nice. Because we'll shoot at the troopers when they start moving, so we'll leave the tank there. We'll start calling people in up here. Berbader. I don't know who I want up here. I'll take Vice. I'll take Eddie. I will take... Oscar... I should have taken Marina, actually, rather than Oscar. Probably just leave the other two CP? No, we gotta move Ramsey. Not Ramsey, Rosie. Because otherwise she's just gonna get murdered by snipers. I'm gonna try and get her in cover and like off to the side. Maybe keep her from getting shot. And now we'll end our turn. Hopefully Frisia is safe, hopefully. Those two shock troopers aren't going to do anything. If they move, they're going to die, so... Reinforcements have appeared. For who? Them. Okay, a bunch of reinforcements just popped in right there. I guess we can't kill those people? Maybe I should have just kept moving the tanks forward? It seems silly to give them infinite troops like that. Everyone I just killed popped back into existence there. I don't approve of that. I'm gonna go ahead and say that. Don't approve of that. Oh, come on. Okay. What kind of shot is that? Can't even see the dude. And it looks like there's ramps up, so that's what they're doing down there. There's grass down there and stuff then. Hello. Oh, come on. You couldn't move slightly further so the tank could kill you. Oh, there we go. That works. Then again, they're probably just going to get reinforcements again anyway, apparently, because that's how this works. They're also going to fire grenades. I forgot they could do that. That might be problematic.
Damage minimal.
Depending on what this Lancer does. I imagine they're all going to start firing grenades, move slightly, fire grenade, move slightly, do nothing, apparently, in this suit's case. Also do nothing. Interesting strategy. Oh, you know why? It's because they're not there. Yeah, it's the scouts that are firing grenades. Never mind.
Underminer fire.
I like how we get that little retaliatory shot before they end their turn. And he's going to just take a front shot at the Shamrock. It's fine. So how are we going to do this if they're just going to instantly, constantly respawn reinforcements like that? Guess maybe I should have had a tank in the north. Or maybe I could get like a Lancer in the south, and then a tank in the north? What are they... This is so weird watching them move like this. You don't have a grenade, dude. Oh, they're stopping their turn the instant they get shot. That's what's going on. So they take minimal damage, but they're just blowing CP, doing nothing effectively. This Lancer, however, he's got three rounds.
Minor damage taken.
Well, one left now, but still, he's got three rounds. And apparently they're done. Alright. And I'm gonna get a bunch of reinforcements, and none of them are going to be a Lancer. Okay. Forgot about that.
Look out for those incendiary rounds. Hiding in the trenches won't keep you safe.
How come we don't get incendiary rounds? Maybe we do later, I don't know. Alright, well, technically we need to move everyone out of here, so... I'll screw you first.
Enemy spotted.
Yeah, I know, chill out. Can I crouch up here? Does not appear we can crouch up here, so... Oh my god, Oscar. Seriously.
Just...
Oh my god, Oscar. Why did you miss that? How did you miss that?
Yes.
I wanted him to kill those two and then shoot this one over there, but that's not going to happen, so we're going to have to reposition a bit. So hopefully he won't get shot by the sniper down there. And we're also effectively just wasted a CP. Okay. I wonder if those snipers respawn. If they do, that's complete bollocks. We need to move those people out. We also need to move at least the Edelweiss away from here. We're going to take a bit of damage from this, but we're also going to run that guy over for the sake of running him over. Actually, you know what? Before we wander too far off here, let's just shoot that mortar into there. I mean, we're going to leave this area anyway. We may as well kill everyone there, except for that Lancer, because freaking Lancer. Working on it. Thing is, they're just gonna respawn.
Entering combat.
Maybe we'll leave the Shamrock back there. Maybe I should turn the tank around as well. Let's do that. I'm worried about that Lancer, as is pretty much standard when I'm driving a tank. I'm worried about Lancers. Do I want to blow it again to move him slightly? Not really. I'd rather move these people out of this zone.
Why should I enjoy seeing dirt?
Why should I enjoy seeing dirt? Apparently. That's the tank. Actually, get around the side. Nothing just happened. Chill out. Don't worry about it. I think I'll put both of our shock troopers over there. They have to go around this building, I think, to get to this base. And we're going to leave the Shamrock down south, which means it might die, but it's also going to attempt to provide cover for us from the south. You two will be in charge of defending this base, effectively. And Frisia, we want you to do what? What do? Could put her over there, then we're in serious danger of being grenaded. Put her over here. It's not what I wanted to do. We're in danger of being shot by the sniper over here, but we at least need to get her out of the incendiary zone, basically. And we will use the other two CP to move the Edelweiss. It's not going to get very far, but at least it will have moved. Now I'm wondering if there's going to be a Lancer coming up that slope that's going to hit him in the back. Probably shouldn't save right now, but I'm going to in case that happens. Maybe he'll miss if I just keep reloading incessantly like a buffoon. Save scum, go! Save scum is best tactic in any game. Not really, but, you know, whatever. Deal with it. Enemy reinforcements. Yep. So at the start of every one of their turns, they get full reinforcements instantly. So... Ow. I wonder if they got their snipers up on the cliff back, though. That's the big deal. If those snipers aren't back, we're and it's sitting a little bit better. Should have rotated the shamrock a little bit, I guess. I can't see him. What is he doing? Still running towards us. All right. Still running. Shoot a grenade? No. Thought he was going to shoot a grenade, but no. And we won't get a counter shot because he didn't shoot at Rosie with that shot, so. I like how they get shot, move slightly, get shot again, and then stop. They're like, well, this isn't working. Let's stop doing that. I'm worried a little bit about this Lancer possibly having enough health to get a shot or two off on the Shamrock and killing it. Oh, you're gonna shoot the treads again, are you? Fantastic. Can you stop doing that? I'd greatly appreciate it if you stop shooting his freaking tracks. He's gonna get at least a shot off. It looks like he'll get two, actually, so he might kill the Shamrock. No, maybe not. I bet... that's a Lancer. That could be a problem. I bet you could get a Lancer in there in the north side. In that grass and have him protected. Largo! Somehow you are alive. Pronounced alive funny, but somehow he's alive. I'm not sure how. Shamrock is almost certainly going to end up dying soon. Argo's dead. Yep. I like the way he died. His freaking ragdolls in this game are a little bit dramatic, but whatever. Gravity on this planet is effectively zero. You get hit by a bullet and flung like 5-6 feet in the air. Come on. Oh, is he gonna kill it this turn? Not quite. But he will die the next time he gets shot at all, so. His reign of slowing down that southern advance is effectively done. I like how that thing shoots. Also, wow. Does a lot of damage. Ookily dookily. Retargeting, where is he shooting? Completely useless location over yonder. Good for me. And it looks like they did not get the scouts up on that cliff bank.
Here we go.
So, we're gonna end up turning this tank around again over here. Because there is a Lancer somewhere around here. Somewhere around here, I don't know where exactly, but there's the enemy tank. Can I hit that from here? Probably it's not going to do much damage, but it will be hit from here. I don't have much chance of hitting it, actually. Let's try and get a little bit further in. That's the little bit further in we're getting, so. Just fire right there. Well, we hit it. Progress, I guess. The Lancer's right there.
Entering combat.
I still... yeah, they have to go around this building to get up here. Lancer's right there, somewhere, but... I'm just gonna take pot shots at this thing, and then I'm gonna put the Edelweiss into the base and let it repair and stuff. And I guess we can do it this Lobo way.
Entering combat.
Which is to say, this way.
Nature.
What does nature lover do? Does that increase your damage? It doesn't appear to increase your accuracy.
Fire!
But we'll never know, because you missed, so good job.
Imperial defenses are finally
weakened. What if this counts as being in the base? It looks like it is, because he's got that status up, and it doesn't appear that it's still the same status up from before, so. Let's fire this guy? No. actually going to shoot in this grass. Hello. As he flies away over there. I want to see if I can get Oscar to kill that guy. Which would limit our risks on the Edelweiss to just that thing, which could do a lot of damage. I don't know. If it does, we're going to have an issue. If it doesn't, we should be fine. Hello. So Lancer down, I'm going to take out this sniper as well, even though both of these guys are going to respawn. I just feel like it's a thing I should do. A sniper is putting really no one at risk, but he exists. And I don't like the fact that he exists, or that he's Imperial. You have no ammo, so never mind, you're going to be doing nothing. You can just chill over here, I don't know, do something. Sniff your finger, I guess. I don't know. Whatever. That was a waste of CP. Should have paid attention to the fact that he didn't have ammo. It gives you a stupid ammo indicator for a reason. They get their free reinforcements again and their billion CP because they have a billion CP. So the Shamrock is dead this turn. That Lancer's gonna kill it. There's nothing we're gonna do about that. They've got their southern sniper back, which I hate. I seriously hate that they get infinite snipers. Snipers are just, they do so much damage and they have an infinite quantity of them, so I dislike that.
Under light fire.
I wouldn't call that light fire. I mean, you're kind of smoking and on fire and all sorts of other stuff. Good shot. Good miss. And we should get a counter on this too. Come on, Rosie! Nice. She had plenty left over. She's also firing into her friends over there. Although at that distance, I don't think it's going to do anything, much less hit. Shamrock's got poor accuracy. Again, because it has no upgrades. So, I guess there's that. Here comes the kill from the Lancer. And boom.
No.
Like how the other guy helped. That was great. Sad days. I know, Zaka, don't worry. It fades out like it's a game over. Do you lose Zaka entirely when he dies? No, it just says retreated. Weird camera angle. Don't know what's going on there, but weird camera angle. So that southern front can start advancing more or less unopposed now. Is he gonna take a shot at us? Yeah. Missed, thankfully. It's gonna take a lot of shots, especially since it seems like Demo Boost does nothing against those. At least it seems like it to me. She has no cover. I didn't realize that. I don't think it'll matter right now, but she's not crouching, so if a sniper decides to shoot at her, she's probably gonna die. And I'm not worried too much about Largo because he is a story-specific character and we can abuse the fact that story-specific characters will not die in this game unless the story says they can. Bosh. I wish these tanks moved. So it wasn't all the way down there. Where is it? Ooh, dear. That's bad. That's real bad. We don't have a lot of CP either. It's a tank, right? So Demo Boost should help, right? But I'm not sure it does. But it's a tank. I don't understand. Let me shoot the thing with Demo Boost. Maybe it does help and the thing just has so much health that it's hard to tell? I don't know. So if we don't move anyone, we can get three shots off with this thing. Oh, I hate the sensitivity on the analog stick. Please don't miss. Thank you. Like, maybe it helps? It's so hard to tell. If we don't move anyone, though, they're going to get hit by that incendiary and probably die. Okay, that hit. Good. I was about to say. So do we want to back off? I probably should have already backed off. Oscar might get hit anyway. Or do we want to just soak the hit and take another shot with the Edelweiss? I'm going to soak the hit and take another shot with the Edelweiss. I really hate the sensitivity sometimes. Nope. Sometimes I hate everything. All the time. Alright, well... stuck. I'm gonna do this, as odd as it might seem initially. If something can hit that, that's ridiculous. What is up with my tires? Tires is freaking out. The reason I did that is because now there's that Lancer over yonder, and Frizzy is still standing there, but... Frizzy is probably gonna go down, all three of the people in that zone are probably gonna die. Reinforcements have appeared. Ray, they're not mine. Sadly. Hey, you know you should shoot at Rosie rather than the person standing in the open right in front of you? Nice dodge. She might actually kill this sniper with the counterfire. Nope, not quite. We shall not dance this day, Frizzy. Your name I mispronounce constantly, but whatever. How long have I been doing this mission? It seems like it's been ages. Probably has been ages. May have to do this mission a third time, depending on what happens here. Which I'd prefer not to do, and I would edit out until I get to the point where I'm about to kill that last tank, probably. Nice aim, dude. She didn't even dodge it. You missed every shot. You're also now dead. At the start of the game, there's so little reason to use anyone other than scouts, but at this point it's so obvious that every unit has like these massive differences in ability to do things. Like at the beginning, you know, shock troopers weren't that much of a threat. Now, shock troopers could kill scouts with like a quarter of their clip, so really don't want to mess with them. Here comes Lancer Bro. Lancer Bro might shoot at Rosie. I'm unsure. He will. He'll probably hit. Or not. At least I'm not the only one that has to suffer through this horrible accuracy issue. Although sometimes I wonder about the AI's ability to aim. Hi, Lancer. He's probably going to take a shot. Only be logical for him to. Might take multiple. Shouldn't matter though, because we're in a base and we will auto repair in bases. I'm really curious what this incendiary is gonna do. Really? That was his whole turn? Just take a shot and stop moving? Alright, I guess they're all gonna do that. What kind of range does she have? Good lord. They're scared to death of Frizia. She's just standing in the open, firing away. Hello. Now trooper v trooper. I'm in cover, he's not, so he's going to take more damage than me, but I'm not going to kill him. Or he'll just dodge, yeah, that's a distinct possibility. You know, you could aim your gun down a little bit when he ducks. I mean, you're still shooting. Lancer round two, is he going to fire again? Oh, he's going to get help from the trooper, too. Ow. And now Rosie's out of cover, which means when she goes down, we're going to lose another CP. Will this kill everyone? Yes, is the prompt answer to that. What even hit him up there? To be honest, I didn't think it would hit Oliver at the very least, but apparently that was irrelevant. Okay. How much CP do we have? Same amount as last time. Need half health though, so. Orders, demo boost, I really don't know if it's doing anything, but I feel like I should use it anyway because I'm shooting tanks. Even though it takes 3 CP and cuts my turns down to basically nothing. Somehow managed to wedge myself permanently in there. Welkin, do not miss. Alright. You didn't miss. You were really close to missing, but you didn't miss.
Entering combat.
I think if he hits all 3 of these shots on the hull of the tank, it'll kill it. We're all or nothing at this point. Oh my god, Welkin. Why? Why, Welkin? Why? Could have been done this turn, but nope. Now we're going to have some serious issues. Because Welkin can't hit stupid targets. I'm pretty sure it would have killed it if he hit that one.
Gallians at 3 o'clock. Distance 600 meters.
Again, I'm going to go ahead and rotate the tank so it is as safe as physically possible. Don't do that. Do that. There we go. That's the direction I wanted to point. Look how Frizzy and this tank are holding this base at this point. So I believe Largo is going to retreat. I believe his time is up after this. Reinforcements have arrived. You can stop getting reinforcements? I haven't killed anyone in a while. Oh no, I killed that scout, that's right. Dodge. Oh well. At least the sniper's dead. I like how Frizzy is a better sniper than the sniper was. Admittedly, if he had taken shots last turn, we would be in a different situation, but... Oh dear. Oh, nice. She's a better scout than the scout is. She's better everything. She's quite good. I like Frizzy. I mean, she's probably gonna die, but... It's not to say I don't like her. Rosie's gonna die, that's for sure, which is gonna take us down to 2 shots next turn if we do demo boost. If I don't do demo boost, that's gonna leave us at... That was some luck right there. What is that gonna leave us at? 6? So we'd be able to do 3 shots? Is it better to do that? I think it might be. Unless, of course, it's not going to kill it in that those 3 shots where Welkin misses a bunch of times. I don't know. Freaking Welkin. Did you forget where you were going there, Trooper Elite? He's probably going to kill it. No. Rosie's just a survivor this mission, apparently. It was like Alicia that last mission, I think. Was it the last mission? No, it was chapter 11. Where she was in the enemy base just dodging shots left and right the whole time. Uh-oh. Again! We're getting some good RNG going here. I approve of this. I approve of the RNG that's occurring right now. I just realized I left the tank in the... I left the tank in the mortar round zone. Is that gonna kill the tank? If that kills the tank, I'm going to have a small rage fit. Are you gonna kill Rosie this time, Lancer? Yep. That looked like it was painful, to be honest. So there goes our CP. And Largo, I'm pretty sure Largo's out of time, so he's gonna retreat. Which doesn't matter, we already lost his CP. Seriously, if this kills the tank, I'm gonna be very unhappy. So very unhappy.
Minor damage sustained.
Alright, minor damage. That's much less than dead. Oh, this is minor damage for everything, so I don't really know what he's on about. Ooh. Interesting location there. You took no damage. Oh, because he healed in the base. we do the demo boost, we've got two shots and one CP. If we don't do the demo boost, we've got four shots. Let's not do the demo boost this turn. I don't even know if it's doing anything, so I'm probably saving CP by not doing it. I'm on fire, but other than that, it seems to be doing alright. Yeah, I think that demo boost does actually do stuff, but it's unnoticeable given this dude's quantity of health. But I think this should be the last one, which means we'll save all these dead people over here. There we go. That mission could have gone better, but, you know, I'm not going for A ranks here. As much as I'd like to have them, I'm going for completion.
Both enemy tanks neutralized.
As well as most of our squad, currently burning to death. C rank, you know. I was expecting a D rank, to be quite honest. Got a gun, because Alicia killed someone for us. And all those people are rescued, because it ended the mission. Hooray!
The watershed battle on the Nagyar Plains ended in the victory of the Gallian forces. It made military history not only with its ferocity, but with the duel that ended it. The Imperial army then fell to retreat, while Gallia's grasp on victory tightened.
Alicia, are you all right?
Welkin. What happened? I can't remember. What did... I was shot, wasn't I? But here I am, alive and fully healed. And it's like... everyone looks at me differently now. Like they're scared. Welkin, did... has something happened to me? Tell me, please!
Alicia.
Sir, may I come in?
Any results on that thing I asked you to look into?
Yes, sir. For starters, this bullet you gave me. Its shape and markings perfectly match rounds used by an experimental Gallian sniper rifle.
I see. So Alicia really was shot by someone inside the Gallian force. So, any leads on who fired it?
Yes, sir. It...
tell me, Kreese.
The night before the shooting, records show Lieutenant Lanzett checked out the rifle.
What? Valdio had the gun? Are you sure that's not some mistake?
It's rare for a tank commander to ask for a sniper rifle, so the clerk remembered him. Sir, only two of those rifles exist right now. One is confirmed to be locked in the arsenal. The other was checked out to Lieutenant Lanza and has yet to be returned. I can't. It's hard for me to believe, too.
Valdio? It couldn't be. Valdio, you in? I guess not. Notes on the Valkyrian race. The anthropology of the Valkyrer. Maybe he was reading up on the enemy. This is his handwriting.
militia must be made to awaken. What?
Alicia must be made to awaken. No matter how much I try, I can think of no other way. I almost wish I had never joined them on that expedition to the Barius ruins. I'm convinced that the inner chamber was built to admit only Valkyra. But the door opened at her touch. That could only mean that the blood of their tribe courses through her veins. Still, I was shocked to find her bathed in that uncanny light that night in the field. Though I doubted my eyes, I never once doubted. That light was the Valkyrian blue flame. Ultimately, I had no choice but to accept the simple truth that Alicia is one of them. I'd already begun to question all I knew. The walls of the temple sanctum were inscribed with the Valkyra's account of history. History as it truly was. We are all taught of the darksome calamity and how their actions forever scorched the land. But this account told a different story. The Valkyra invaded this land from the north, slaying the indigenous Darkson people as they came. Their grasp of Ragnite technology and the art of war were vastly superior. They trained the destructive power of Ragnite on the Darkson's land, burned it to ash, then had the gall to pass the blame for their inhuman deeds off on their Darkson slaves. Darksons have borne that stigma ever since, while the Valkyra became godlike saviors. The victors simply rewrote the history books. The Barius ruins promulgate a lie to all but their own descendants as hard fact. Reading about the Valkyra's power, the true face of these saviors, left me stunned. Yet at the same time, I cannot help but think of how useful it could be to us now. Since then, I've investigated every text and report on the Valkyra I could find. They lead me to believe that at least a few scions of the Valkyra must have survived to this day. All across Europa, these rare individuals live and die unaware of their own nature. But history has recorded rare cases of individuals who have awakened to their powers. Their stories share one common thread. All of them suffered grave wounds before awakening. If those accounts are correct, the blood of the Valkyra stirs at the approach of death. Their power, having slept for thousands of years, bursts awake at one step shy of the end. Once awakened, if one of these individuals takes hold of the refined Ragnite arms of their ancestors, they make their mark on history as one of the Valkyra of old. I couldn't stop myself. I stole the Valkyrian lance and shield out of the university archive. Supposedly, their blood serves to amplify the Ragnite's natural power. I have no idea what science lies behind it. Perhaps it's a consequence of their origins in the Ragnite-rich northern regions. Regardless of the reason, the Valkyria's life force itself calls forth a reaction from the stone. The enemy Valkyria decimated our forces on the Nagyar Plains. I could not afford to stay my hand on account of ethics. I had the rifle, and I forced myself to use it. I shot her. I placed the lance and shield on her unconscious form. I was racked with insecurity and guilt, hands red with blood of my best friend's love. But now I know. The choice I made was right.
Faldio!
Hello, Lieutenant Gunther. Is something wrong?
Faldio, where is he?
Sir, Captain Verrat just called him in. He left only a minute ago.
Baldio. I'm only going to ask you this once. Was it you who shot Alicia?
Yeah. I shot her.
Tell me why. Why did you have to shoot her?
The people. Gallia needed her. Now let me ask you a question. How else do you think we could have won that battle? If not for Alicia's power, Gallia would have most certainly lost.
I still can't.
And not just this battle. I'm talking about Gallia's future. How else are we supposed to survive, Welkin? Caught on either side by giants. It's Alicia. Our Valkyria. She's the only one who can protect us from them.
Wrong. Our side gaining power won't end this war. All it does is escalate the conflict.
That's enough. Listen to each other. You may both be right, but still, you're both very wrong. I don't claim to have the perfect answer either. However, regardless of the reason, attacking one of your own comrades is deplorable. By Gallian military law, I remand you to the stockade until further notice, Faldio. And you, Welkin. 24 hours in isolation for engaging in fisticuffs.